Welcome to a lesson on subsets. The goals of this video are to define a subset and proper subset, and then also use the proper notation for both. If every member of set A is also a member of set B, then A is a subset of B, and we use this notation here. We can also say that A is contained in B. And there is an alternate notation. If we switch the order of the notation, we can say that B is a superset of A, or that B includes A. Notice using either notation, the subset symbol opens towards the B or points toward the A in either case. If A is not a subset of B, we can use this notation here where we put a slash through the subset symbol. So looking at sets A, B, and C, notice that all of the members of set C are also members of set A. 1 is in both set C and A, 2 is in set C and A, and 8 is in set C and A. So we can say that C is a subset of A, or we can say A is a superset of set C. Now looking at set B and C for a moment, notice that set B contains 2 and 8, but does not contain the number 1. Therefore, we can say that C is not a subset of set B. If A is a subset of B, but A is not equal to B, we can say that A is a proper subset of B, written using this notation here. So notice that it's the same symbol as the subset symbol, except the bar underneath the symbol is omitted, or we can include the bar and put a slash to it, showing that the two sets are not equal to each other. Taking a look at these three sets here, let's take a look at set A and set B first. Notice that all of the elements in B are also in set A, but they're not equal sets. So we can say that B is a subset of A, and since the two sets are not equal to each other, we can also say that B is a proper set of A. But now if we take a look at sets A and C, notice that set A contains A, B, C, D, E, and set C also contains A, B, C, D, E, but in a different order. And since the order doesn't matter, we can say that C is a subset of A, or A is a subset of C. But since A and C are equal to each other, they are not proper sets of each other. So we can say that C is not a proper set of A, or A is not a proper subset of C. Let's take a look at two more examples. We want to use either the subset symbol or the proper subset symbol when appropriate, given these two situations. So set A is a set of people living in Phoenix, Arizona, USA, and set B is the set of people living in Arizona. And since Phoenix, Arizona is in the state of Arizona, we could say that A is a subset of B. And since set A does not equal set B, we can say that A is also a proper subset of B. And since being a proper subset gives us more information about the two sets, the proper subset notation would be more appropriate, even though they are both true. Looking at our second example, C is the set of weekdays, and D is the set Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. So these two sets are actually equal to each other. So we could say that C is a subset of D, and D is also a subset of C. But since they're not equal, we cannot use the proper subset notation. So this would be the best notation to use in this situation. And this might remind you of inequality symbols. Remember, when working with inequality symbols, if we have this symbol, it's just less than. If we have this symbol here, it's less than or equal to. So this bar here represents that the two sets could be equal to each other, whereas in proper subsets cannot be equal to each other. There's a few more minor things to mention about subsets. The empty set is a subset of any set. And the empty set is a proper set for all sets except for itself, the empty set. From these two statements, it follows that if set A has n elements, it has 2 to the nth power subsets. And if set A has n elements, it has 2 to the n minus 1 proper subsets. Notice the minus 1 because we can't count A as its own subset. Let's take a look at a couple of examples of this. Determine the number of subsets and proper subsets of the given sets. So number 1 has 2 elements, so n is equal to 2. So there's supposed to be 2 to the nth power subsets. So 2 to the second would give us 4 subsets. And the proper subsets would be 2 to the second minus 1. That'll be 3 proper subsets. Let's go ahead and list them for this example. Set B would be a subset if B contained the element A. Set C would be a subset if it contained the element B. Set D would be a subset if it contained the element AB. And then lastly, E would be a subset if it was the empty set. So notice we have 4 subsets. And then for the proper subsets, we'd have to eliminate set D because we couldn't use 2 sets that are equal to be proper subsets. For number 2, we have n equals 3. So 2 to the third would be the number of subsets. There are 8 subsets. And for the number of proper subsets, it's going to be 2 to the third minus 1. That'll be 8 minus 1, or 7 proper subsets. If you want, you may want to pause the video and see if you can list all of them. But we're going to stop here for this video. Next, we'll take a look at set operations and Venn diagrams. I hope you found this helpful.